Hi, I am Deng Wan, and I'm system engineer for TI's mmWave sensors. Today, we are showing a demo of short-range radar for advanced driver assistance systems using TI's 77 GHz RF CMOS radar. In this demo, the sensor is configured to use one of the three transmit channels and all four receiver channels, with a range resolution as high as 4 cm and maximum detection range of 40 meters. Two videos will be shown. In the first video, the raw IDC data is collected and post-processed on a PC. In this test scene, the parking lot is about 24 meters in width and about 36 meters in depth. The radar sensor is placed 3 feet above the ground with a field of view of 120 degrees in azimuth. Notice we have cars parked at various distances. Plot 2 shows the signal amplitude at different ranges. The green line represents static range profile. Other velocity profiles are represented by different colors. The peaks correspond to objects seen by the radar at various range. In this time instance, nothing is moving. The reflections seen in the range of 1 to 6 meters are the ground clutter. Detection at 50 meters is a tree. Multiple detection points around 25 to 30 meters are from the parked car on the left. Plot 3 is a heat map representing information of range and velocity, with the colors representing signal power in dB. Plot 4 shows the detection and classroom results. The red circles are the detected points corresponding to the targets seen by the radar. Each rectangle is a cluster of points belonging to the same objects. Plot 5 indicates an occupancy grid with incorporated velocity information. The grid covers plus or minus 20 meters horizontally and 40 meters vertically, with a cell size of 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters. The color of the occupied cell indicates the radial velocity. As the car drives to the field of view of the radar, it can be effectively detected along the driving path. We can see that on plot 4, the physical geometry predicted by the cluster is very reasonable. On plot 5, we see very rich point cloud representing the moving cars. Radar can also detect pedestrian as soon as she enters the scene. One important observation is that the micro-Doppler information is also revealed in a range Doppler heat map, which is critical for pedestrian recognition. Notice the radar can detect a person as she leaves a car and walks away. Detecting a small object in front of another large one is a very hard problem. However, with the rich spatial and velocity information shown in plot 5, we are able to separate these two objects. This is the second real-time demo video. The test scene is very similar to the previous one. Now the data is processed on a TI TDA3 SoC processor in real-time, and the detected points and classroom results are sent to the PC for visualization. We can see that both pedestrians and cars can be detected and clustered with reasonably high accuracy. Thanks for watching our demo. For more information, please visit ti.com at the link below.